Hi, this is Elena Francis with Sound Shock, and I'm at the Ragnarok Festival with Månegarm. Would you guys like to introduce yourselves to the wonderful viewers?
I'm Markus, guitarist.
I'm Jonas, the other guitarist.
How are you guys finding the festival so far? I know you've just arrived.
You know, we arrived early, very early flight here, so we just put in our stuff and have a couple of hours of sleep, and now we're back drinking some beer, so. So far, so good. Yeah.
Are you looking forward to seeing any particular bands today?
No.
Actually, no. I think better bands yesterday, maybe like Enslaved.
So I understand you're working on demos for a new material.
Yeah.
Is this for an album or an EP?
Yeah, we started recording some songs in the rehearsal room and. We see what happened. Right now we don't have a record label.
Oh really?
So we label less, yes.
What happened to Regain Records?
That's a long story, but financial problems and
okay.
A lot of problems.
Yeah, a lot of problems.
Yeah.
So we're leaving them and looking for a new label. So we're negotiating with a couple of labels.
Okay.
We'll see what happened.
So you've really got interest then?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So what does this new material sound like?
It's in the wings of the old stuff, but maybe some, I don't know, what would you say, more aggressive?
Yeah, I think so this time. A little bit more
aggressive.
Black metal, maybe.
Yeah. Back to the roots.
So do you know how long it's going to be until it gets released? How long you've finished the material?
It depends on when we get a label.
Okay. So at the moment this must be the earlier stages, no song titles, no album titles released yet.
Yeah, we have some song titles and things like that. Yeah. So like 4 songs recorded or something.
Yeah, so far.
They're only demos, so just to feel the songs and how they fit into the album.
Okay. You guys recently came off the Neckbreakers Ball tour.
Yeah.
Which sadly the London date was moved.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was too
moved
bad,
to France.
Yeah.
Enough. But how was that tour?
It was great. It was great. Great bands and the organization is always good with automation.
Yeah.
Maybe not that crowded like the Haydn Festival in 2008.
Oh, yeah.
But it was good.
That's a big variation of bands on there, wasn't it?
Yeah, of course.
So I'm sure you won over many new fans.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
That's why we did the tour to get. Fans and expand our fan base.
Yeah. I want to talk to you about your Natvesen album. You guys did a video for Winter Megan. Why did you choose that song from the album?
The story in the song,
maybe. Yeah, it could have been that.
We thought
that could have been a quite good idea for a video, maybe.
What exactly is the story in the video?
Well, it's like this Viking king, or what you can call him, that's been mesmerized by this creature, this beautiful creature.
That symbolizes winter.
Yeah.
So it's a little story about the elements in nature and the interaction with the human, maybe the human soul and all that. I think. So it's.
Mayan!
Yeah.
Someone's a fan.
Yeah.
You guys have been going for quite a while. You're one of the sort of longer running folk metal bands.
Yeah.
What do you hope to achieve with Månegarm? Do you have a sort of goal that you'd love to do?
Well, I don't know. Of course, a goal will be to like headline festival.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Maybe. Live on the music and
I guess so. That's like for every band.
What's been the proudest achievement for your band so far?
This interview, maybe. Right.
Awesome.
Yeah. Have you been to North America yet or anything like
that? Yeah, we played in Canada, I would say.
Oh wow! Yeah. That's pretty good. Not very often many folk metal bands go over there.
Yeah. It was great. It was a festival last year in Canada.
Yeah.
pretty big with Sodom on the bands.
Sodom?
Sodom. Yeah. It's cool.
So it's been a couple of years since the last album came out. What have you guys been doing? Is it just touring?
Yeah, you know, we're
mostly touring.
Yeah, playing festivals. And, you know, we did this 24 gig tour, so after that we had like a two month break after that, just getting back in shape.
Starting to work on new material.
Yeah.
So what's your writing process? How do you write together or separately while you're on tour or while you're on a break?
So far it has been like me and Eric, who writes the music, we have done it at home and then we have taken it to the rehearsal room and then maybe someone has ideas and incorporated. But this time we've done it a little bit different since we're recording it and everybody can be with us from the start and we can try new ideas and so it's better, I think.
When you're writing it, do you start with the guitars and implement the folk stuff later? Or
Starting the riffing and then see what happens, basically. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
So what are your immediate future plans after this festival? Back to the writing?
And recording songs in the rehearsal room, and then we're doing a couple of summer festivals in Germany, playing in Italy this summer for the first time. But basically we concentrate on finding a label and